Work it all the time. My girl's name is Sonora. I tell you, friends, I adore her. And when she dances, oh brother, she's a hurricane in all kinds of weather. Jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line, rock your body on time.
Oh yeah, Beetlejuice. technically I've been reviewing films that like everyone's all in love with, like Titanic and all that stuff. But recently I've been doing films that big old success films that people like love, can't get enough of. But Beetlejuice, that was actually a recommendation by some kid. You know, some kid saw me. You know, he noticed me, like, see my film reviews, so he asked me to do Beetlejuice, and forgot that kid's name, because it was a while back. He asked me to do it, and I'm finally doing it as of right now. But Beetlejuice, it's a very good film. I had nightmares as a kid from seeing this film. But yet, like, I don't know, like, it was a nightmare, but yet I kept going back to see it. Go back for more. You know, it's kind of like an unusual thing to do. Well, the movie's directed by Tim Burton, of course. You know, Tim Burton done the, Batman series, the two Batman film series. Yeah, Tim Burton's films have been quite, wouldn't say unusual, but it's quite the horror comedy, much a la Edward Scissorhands with Vincent Price. But, Beetlejuice has got to be one of the best films of Tim Burton's career, because this film had won an Academy Award for Best Makeup. So, yeah, so you gotta give it that. It's released in 1988. Winona Ryder's in it. She's about 16 at the time. Michael Keaton plays Beetlejuice, of course. That's so cool. Alec Baldwin, Jim Davis, they played like the lead couple. And in the film, you know, these two couple, you know, they're decorating house, you know, New England, and then like, they go out of town and they're coming back and then like they get in a car accident and end up dying. And like throughout the film, you know, they try to get back to ordinary life, but they know it's not gonna happen because they're dead. But I actually like a film. It's kind of like a bio-exorcist film. That's pretty cool. And technically, what the example Tim Burton is trying to set with, what if death is exactly like life? You know, waiting in line, doing paperwork, pretty much like the same thing, you know. But if death is really like that way, some people really want to live forever, because like what I meant was, if death is like that, then what's the point of being all worried about death if death is going to be like life? Do what you did when you were alive, you know, paperwork, taxes. Technically, we all gotta live the life we're only gonna see once, but I don't know, this film is a very good film. I love it. Two thumbs up on a scale of 1 to 10, a perfect 10, because at the film, I don't know, it's like, it's kind of like a weird film, kind of hard to explain, you know? Because when I do my film reviews, I'm just gonna grab a random film to start reviewing it, because I'll watch the film and do a background check on the film, but I don't know, because I've been seeing Beetlejuice for years, and still to this day, I kind of don't understand it, and I don't understand like how to explain the film. The film is kind of a very good film. So, sometime after Beetlejuice in 88, in 1990, Tim Burton started working on a sequel, but somehow he put that aside to do the two Batman films. So by like at least 97, like the production was getting ready, but Tim Burton said, no, we just waited too late, because Winona Ryder was just too old for the role. And also the sequel just never happened. But it's a very good film. Excellent work. Pretty good boost in Tim Burton's career. So if anyone else has any films for me to review, tell me and I'll review them. Thank you.